Here are 10 big mistakes that spiritual entrepreneurs are making. These mistakes that most spiritual entrepreneurs are making will keep your business stuck and will prevent you from becoming successful in the future. I end up working with a lot of spiritual entrepreneurs because they are really into manifestation, which is the basis of what I teach. And there are some really big mistakes that I see spiritual entrepreneurs making all of the time. And I personally have made a lot of these mistakes myself in the past, and they have really held me back. A lot of these mistakes will stop people from making good money or even making any money at all in their businesses. So it's really important to address these mindset blockages. So today I'm highlighting some of the biggest mistakes that I have noticed so that you can finally get the results that you deserve in your business. And I have created a blog post, podcast, and a video out of this content so you can consume this content in your favorite type of media. My name is Kath Kyle, and I'm the author of Stamp Goals book, and I'm so happy that you're here. I help content creators and change makers manifest business success through spirituality, self-belief, and strategy. And I help you master your marketing, manifestation, and money mindset. And I would like to know if any of these mistakes or these things that I'm about to raise today have been holding you back, or if you used to struggle with any of them in the past. And I'd also like to know what you think of my content, what you like best, and what improvements you'd like to see in the future. And if you have any questions for me, I love to hear your questions so I can help you out and also answer them in future content pieces. So let me know by leaving a comment on my blog, YouTube channel, or send me a DM on Instagram at Kath_Kyle. So here are the 10 big mistakes that spiritual entrepreneurs are making. Number one, waiting for alignment before taking action. This is one of the biggest mistakes I see spiritual entrepreneurs making. There is a myth going around in the entrepreneurial world that you shouldn't take any action at all in your business if you're not in a 100% happy mood and you feel very excited about the task that you're doing. People are saying that if you don't feel in a great mood while you're working, then you'll bring your bad vibes to your business, and anything you do while you are in a bad mood will give you bad luck in your business. So let me just say that I am a massive fan of starting a business that you feel in alignment with, and also creating products that you feel in alignment with. That makes total sense to me because you have to believe in your products to be able to sell them, and loving what you do will make you much more motivated to help other people. But I'm not a fan of the advice that if you wake up in a bad mood or you're feeling tired, that you should just take the whole day off and do what you feel like, watch Netflix and eat a big tub of ice cream. I am much more a fan of commitment and sticking to your word. If you have promised your customers or your audience that you are going to do something for them, then I believe that you should deliver that, even if you aren't feeling in the best mood in the world. I believe that trust is more important than just doing what we feel like. We need to trust ourselves to do what we have promised ourselves that we will do. And we need our customers to be able to trust us to help them get results. I don't understand how some of these coaches make any money at all if they just tell their clients that they're not in the right vibration to show up to their coaching call that their clients have already paid for. Fair enough, things happen that do prevent us from sticking to our promises, like kids get sick, people get too sick to work, disasters do happen, but most of the time we are perfectly able to show up to work and stick to our promises. So it makes sense to be careful about what you commit to in the first place if you know that you are the type of person to regret showing up. I personally don't like a lot of appointments filling up my calendar. Most of the time, I love to be on my own creating new things, so this is how I choose to spend most of my time. And I do 100% believe in sticking to my commitments. So if I do schedule something with somebody, I will do my very best to not only show up, but also be early because I don't like to be late for people. But I have suffered from a lot of insomnia in the past, and whenever I would have a bad night's sleep, which would be often, I would still show up to work at my business because I am committed to it. The great thing about owning your own business is that a lot of the time you can swap tasks in and out depending on what you're in the mood for. But I believe that if you have decided that you are going to work for 3 hours, 5 days a week between, say, 1 p.m. and 3 p.m, then this is exactly what you should do, even if you wake up and you're just not feeling it. If you consistently don't feel like working on your business, either you're in the wrong type of business for you, or you are doing the wrong type of work within your business. And another thing that I hear spiritual people talk about all the time is that no wonder everything went wrong last month because Mercury was in retrograde. And if you follow this logic to its natural conclusion, next time Mercury is in retrograde, that means that everything is just going to go wrong for you. And I don't like to give my power away like this. I decide what I'm doing and I stick to it. Simple as that. Sometimes it doesn't work out exactly as I want, but I just move on and keep going. No blame, no excuses. I just keep my eye on my goals and I just keep moving towards them. Mistake number two is saying that you don't care about money. A lot of spiritual entrepreneurs don't feel like it is spiritual to talk about money, to charge what they're worth, and to focus on money at all. So they often throw around the statement that they don't care about money. And first of all, this can't possibly be true. Every single one of us needs money to survive. Either we ourselves need to bring in money, or someone else needs to bring in money and give it to us, or they need to be providing resources that are paid for using money. Someone somewhere has needed money to pay for your food, your accommodation, your electricity, your phone, and your computer. Without money, how can you survive? We all need money, so therefore we all need to care about money. Saying you don't care about money is sending a very powerful signal that you are not open to the abundance that is rightfully yours. A lot of people think it sounds greedy to say that they care about money and that it's a lot more spiritual to say that they care about people, not money. However, if we look at the analogy about putting on your own oxygen mask before you help other people, the same applies to money. Before you can truly help other people, you have to have your own basic needs met. If you're hungry and cold, you're not going to be at your best for helping other people meet their needs. So we have to be grateful for money first and foremost. If we are grateful for money, then that means we care about money. I used to say myself that I didn't care about money when I was broke. Then, after I started a business, I realized that I had to care about money because my business would not survive without making any money. By definition, you are not in business until you have started to make money, so you have to care about money if you have a business. Mistake number three, avoiding masculine energy. A lot of spiritual entrepreneurs have a lot of feminine energy. Feminine and masculine energy is not about whether you are a man or a woman, it's about your energy. Feminine energy is all about being in the flow, being creative, going within and receiving. Masculine energy is all about being direct and taking action and knowing what you want and going for it. And a lot of spiritual entrepreneurs are so far into their feminine energy, doesn't matter whether they're a man or a woman, that they are not even aware of what they truly want, and they're not taking any action to get any results in their businesses. For me personally, I have been far too much in my masculine energy for most of the 10 years I've been in business. And just in the last couple of years, I have tried to strike a good balance between masculine and feminine energy and have felt a lot more balanced as a result. We need a good balance of both masculine and feminine energies because we are in co-creation with the universe. We trust that the universe will provide for us, but the universe also asks that we play our part and take the necessary action. Mistake number 4, trying to stay positive all the time. The belief that we have to stay positive all the time is very prevalent in the self-help community. There are so many books on positive thinking and so many people are teaching that the key to business success is just to think positive all of the time and you'll manifest exactly what you want. And I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with trying to be positive. It is generally a very good thing to be positive more of the time because being positive will help you to enjoy everything that you do a lot more and naturally you will have more success as a result. But the problem arises when you are trying to stay positive all of the time. And it's just not possible to stay positive all of the time. We have been given a whole range of negative and positive emotions for a reason. There are times when it's perfectly normal and acceptable to feel negative emotions. And it would actually be a bit strange to think positive emotions or to feel positive emotions during these times. For example, when someone has died or someone has been hurt or abused or is going through a hard time, naturally, when the people that you care about get hurt or you yourself get hurt or you're in pain or you miss out on something that you wanted, it's perfectly acceptable and right that you should feel negative emotions. The healthiest thing that you can actually do is to fully feel all of your feelings, all of your emotions, and don't try to fight them at all. Don't try to push them away. Don't try and pretend that they're not there. Just accept them and allow them to completely be there. But then, after you've accepted them, after you've acknowledged them, then release them and let them go so that you are free to move on and experience something different. Clinging on to emotions is not healthy. Riding the waves of life and taking the ups and downs when they arise is the best thing you can do. To experience all emotions is what makes us human. Without the downs, we wouldn't know how good it feels to experience the ups. Mistake number 5, not expecting challenges to occur. Spiritual entrepreneurs often say that if things don't feel right and if things don't work out straight away, then it's not meant to be and that they should give up. But that's not how life works. The first time we do anything for the first time, it always feels awkward, slow, and challenging. If you were a kid and you just gave up on learning to walk because you kept falling down and it just felt so awkward, you never would have learned to walk in the first place. Expecting challenges to occur is much healthier because challenges are to be expected and also welcomed. If you are being challenged, it means that you are growing, and with growth comes a feeling of achievement and success, which are very nice feelings to feel. Businesses are the ultimate self-development program because there is just one challenge after another. You are always learning something new and growing. And if you are not learning something new as a business owner, it means your business is going backwards. It's static or it's not yet taken off. As spiritual entrepreneurs, we should welcome challenges because we have the tools to deal with them much better than non-spiritual entrepreneurs. As soon as we embrace the fact that businesses and our entire lives are full of challenges, we can then experience life with more ease and grace. When we ride the wave of challenges, we feel exhilarated and we can legitimately say that things are easy. I've always enjoyed the challenges of having a business, and that's why I've always said that having a business is easy. I've actually never once thought of my business as hard because I am constantly comparing the fun game of building a business to things that I've truly felt hard, like long-term sickness or horrific accidents. And as I keep my mindset there in the place of this is easy, the actions that I take in my business always seem easy to me. Mistake number 6, being scared that your thoughts are creating reality. A lot of spiritual entrepreneurs have heard that thoughts become things, and they take it so literally that they are scared to think a bad thought. The thing is that yes, we do have a lot of power over our own lives, but we don't have the ultimate power over the whole universe, and we can't change the laws of the universe, so we are just not as powerful as that. Manifesting good things is much easier than manifesting bad things. I believe that we are always offered some degree of protection in our lives, even if we are thinking bad thoughts. I believe that we are constantly being protected and cared for, and even though bad things happen to us, we can always handle them and can grow from them, either in this life or the next. I believe that sustained belief systems are what affects change in our own lives, and even then we may have to wait a long time for things to actually manifest. I don't believe that random negative thoughts change your entire reality. For example, really weird random thoughts pop into my mind all of the time, and I sometimes think, where on earth did that come from? I do not even believe that thought in the slightest. That is a very extreme and a very negative thought. And then I just dismiss it and go about my day as normal. I don't make that mean anything about myself. However, if I'm constantly thinking the same negative thoughts over and over again, such as I'll never earn that much money because of X, Y, and Z, then I start to pay attention and realize that this might actually be an ingrained belief system of mine that is probably affecting my results in my life. Mistake number 7, believing that you always made the right choice in the past. A lot of people say that it doesn't matter what choice you make because whatever you choose is always the best choice. And I don't agree with this line of thinking. There are a lot of things that I've done in the past that I wished I had chosen to do something different. Like, for example, the moment I chose to fly down a steep hill on my bike as an 8-year-old with a friend on the back of my bike, and that ended with my face crushed into the concrete and breaking my teeth. And like the day when I decided to put my fingers in my juicer and I broke my fingers. And yes, the results weren't pretty, and I'm living with the consequences of both of these actions and will be for the rest of my life. And I think on both of these occasions, I made the wrong choice. However, I try not to look back with constant regret because that's just not helpful. We can't go back and change the past. But if faced with either of these decisions again in the future, you can bet that I would not be making the same mistake again. And that's part of the joys of life. That's part of the learning experience of life. We learn things that might not necessarily be good for us at the time. And we feel like, oh, I wished I'd made a different decision. And then when that decision comes up in the future, we can make a better decision in the future. Not all of our decisions have been the best ones for us, but we learn and we grow from them, and that is the most important thing. Mistake number 8, thinking there is nothing more important than feeling good. I hear a lot of spiritual entrepreneurs talking about how the most important thing in life is to feel good, that it is their job to get back into alignment and feel joy on all occasions. And I used to believe this myself, and I no longer believe that feeling good is the most important thing in life. The effect of focusing on feeling good above all else means you effectively have to really distance yourself from getting too close to people, because real people have real problems. But if you and your spiritual friends all agree that you all just have to focus on feeling good, and anyone who dares to bring the vibe down in your friendship group gets banished for good, it will be a very shallow group indeed. The best relationships are based on people being honest and open with each other and going through challenges, struggles, and having joyful times together. If you try and have friendships that are only based on a positive vibe, that means during your downtimes, you will be totally alone because you'll be too scared to reach out for help from anyone else, and you will never tell anybody that you ever went through any struggles, and you'll just be lying to everybody. You'll say that everything has always been perfect in my life and will always be perfect, and I'm always perfect and I'm such a perfect person. And who wants to be around perfect people? Because it makes them feel bad about themselves, because there's no such thing. There's no such thing as a perfect person. Everybody has ups and downs of emotions. And another problem with focusing on feeling good to the detriment of all else is that you can't ever truly help anyone else. Because to help other people, you need to hear and see their struggles, and you need to offer your solutions or your advice to them. If you shut down all forms of negativity from coming out of other people's mouths, you'll not be able to help them. For businesses to make any money, they need to be able to solve people's problems. You need to take them from lack to a solution. So you need to immerse yourself in both the negative and the positive side of your customers' results. Mistake number 9, making it all about you and what you want all of the time. A lot of spiritual teachers encourage people to focus exclusively on what they want, and if you do this, you can't possibly help anybody else. The very nature of business is that there is an exchange of equal value. You give something of value to help someone else, and they give something of value to help you, which is money. If you only ever focus on yourself and what you want, you'll never care enough to put effort into helping someone else, and therefore your business won't take off. Mistake number 10, avoiding doing the deep work. A lot of entrepreneurs become more spiritual on their journey because they realize that their mindset is always totally responsible for their results in business. Therefore, it's hard to ignore mindset or spirituality when you are a business owner. A lot of people hear of spiritual practices that will help them de-stress and manifest more, such as meditation, visualization, affirmations, going to retreats, and breathing exercises. And these practices are very helpful. But if they are the only form of spirituality being practiced, it can lead to spiritual bypass. Spiritual bypassing means to practice spiritual techniques without addressing any of your beliefs or emotions that are causing problems in your life. For example, someone who does meditation every day might wonder why they are still having regular angry outbursts at their family for no apparent reason. One of the reasons could be that they had issues related to their childhood that they have bottled up and refused to look at, and they now have self-esteem issues and they are letting people take advantage of them, and it's causing them to build up this anger which they then explode at their family, and they have no idea what's causing it. And if you notice that you have a lot of the beliefs that I have mentioned today, like trying to force everything to be positive in your life or saying that money doesn't matter, it might be that you need to start delving a little bit deeper into your own spiritual journey. Doing the deep work means that you acknowledge that you have certain ingrained belief systems and then you release them. And I have a whole process that takes you through all of these steps in my Stamp Goals book. It's also one of the many bonuses in the bonus bundle, which is valued at $297, that you get when you buy either my Kindle or my paperback book on Amazon. And you can head over to Amazon and look for Stamp Goals book to check that out. And I hope you can see how valuable it is to look at your belief systems so that you can finally get the success that you deserve in business. And if you are interested in starting a new business, or you are interested in getting better results in your existing business, you might be wondering how you can plan to take your business to the six-figure level. And I have created a free workshop to help you do just this, called How to Plan Your Dream Six-Figure Business in 30 Days. And in this free workshop, I show you how to plan your dream six-figure business in 30 days that fits your personality, desires, and ideal lifestyle, and make money from a brand new business even if you have no experience or product to sell. And this workshop is valued at $77 and is part of my Dream Business Blueprint course. And I'm giving you free access to this workshop and an associated workbook for a limited time. And you can get that by going to kathkyle.com/blueprint. And next time I am sharing how to use music to get powerful manifestation results. So make sure you subscribe to my podcast, Manifest Business Success, my YouTube channel, Kath Kyle, and follow me on Instagram at Kath_Kyle so you don't miss that. And I'm also going to let you know via email when my next piece of content has arrived. And I'm currently giving away 4 brand new free gifts every month to my email subscribers that you can't get anywhere else. So don't miss that. And you can subscribe by opting in to any of my free gifts, such as my free Manifestation Milestones board pack. And this free Manifestation Milestones board pack is the ultimate motivator to help you manifest more business success. From this one pack, you can create both a vision board and an achievement board to help you feel good about what you've already achieved and manifest even more. And this Manifestation Milestones board printable pack will help you recognize and celebrate all of the amazing milestones and goals that you are achieving in your business, which is so exciting. And you can get that by going to kathkyle.com/milestones. And now it's your turn to go and put your stamp on the world.